All right, guys, I got a video I want to make for you, and a little jingle I want to present to you. You may have heard it before, you that are about my age. It goes, which one of these is not like the other? Which one of these are not the same? I'll let you be the judge. Because one of these I didn't make, but somebody else made. Give up. That's the same rock. This one's been traveling. I made this out of your rock and thought I would send it to you to brighten up your day. This lost lake is one of the best ones I've made. Beautiful material makes a point look good. Mr. Paleo Man, this is made from some of the rock I sent him, Hornstone. And I mean, he really flattened that thing out. That's a beautiful point. It's just flatter than a board, and to make one that flat, that wide, it's just unreal. I've been working on trying to get one that flat. And I may have gotten one that flat, but nowhere near that wide. I made this one last week. I was pleased with that. But this one right here is so cool. It doesn't appear to have just a great deal of pressure flaking on it. But then that little edge work is so cool. It's like a four beveled blade. He don't know it, but I know it, that he was on the edge of the rock, because that brown shows up when you're on the edge of the rock. And this right here amazes me. See this strike right here? It goes all the way down right there. I know that was guided by his billet. This goes, and I know what he done probably. Probably took out a big stack that was right in there, because I have some of the awfulest times with this Hornstone stacking up right in the middle. I threw away two or three pieces because I'd stack up right there, right in the middle. That's a beautiful piece right there. Paleo Man, I appreciate it. You sent it at a good time, too. That's awesome. Now I own a Lost Lake and a Pine Tree, two Capenas, a huge Dixon, a Jax Reef. I'm trying to think if I'm leaving anything else out. I don't think I am. While I had the camera on, I was going to show you these few pieces right here that I had been making out of the obsidian that my CO buddy had sent me. And he sent me three slabs, and you've seen it in an earlier video. He sent me three slabs about a quarter inch thick and two nodules. And this is, and I mentioned in an earlier video, I had broken two out of the three slabs that I had worked on and got a few little pieces out of it. Well, this was the last slab, which was the biggest of the ones he sent me, and I broke it half in two. But I still ended up getting this cool little side-notched Elko That's some sweet material. Tricky, yeah, to me it is. This is out of one of the nodules. You can see that big flake right there traveled all the way across to about right there, and then I come back and caught it and cleaned it up a little bit. But this can probably use some more thinning. I think I could probably thin it some more right in here, but I wanted to get this blade made out of it, such as it is, and show it before I destroy it, because I've noticed with this stuff here that one little misstrike, and I mean, it's a goner. And the funniest thing about this obsidian, for instance, you can strike that thing. There could be a ridge right here, and you know in your mind that thing's going to travel that ridge. Well, I'll hit that ridge, and that thing liable to split uphill this way just flying, or the other way. To me, it's so unpredictable as to how those flakes are going to travel when you strike that thing. Some of them will dip in, some of them will stray to the left and to the right, and I mean, they'll travel, that's for certain. But predictability with this stone is just, it's beyond me right now. So I know that any given strike that I made on it, that piece right there would have been gravel, or at least broke half in two. That come out of one of the nodules that was sent me, and I wanted to show you that anyway. It's a little shy of 4.5 inches long. It's 4 3/8, 2 1/8 wide, and pretty thin. Considering what I started with, it was about it's close to 2 inch thick nodule, I guess. But that makes a pretty piece just like it is, without any notches. And that's all percussion flakes. There's no pressure flakes involved in it. I at least wanted to show my buddy that I got that much out of one of the big pieces of obsidian. That's some pretty, pretty stuff. This is a little bit greener looking than this. This is much, much blacker, darker. This one right here is what I really wanted to show you. It's an awesome piece. Cool little edge work on that. I had about an inch and, well, the last couple of days it rained about 1 5/10. Inch of it fell within 30 minutes yesterday. So the grounds I've got to walk are no doubt gleaming with arrowheads right now. And I'll mention this, unfortunately, the old stomping grounds is not one of them that I can walk now. One of the last times I was there, I stopped and hunted it. One of the farmer's vehicles was there, but having permission, I stopped and looked at it, was walking it, and one of the three farmers, when he got back to his truck, he approached me and he said we didn't want anybody walking it with crops in it. He said he didn't mind us walking it beforehand or afterwards, but not while the crops was in it. But in fact, one of the three last year gave me permission. The day he gave me permission to walk it, the tobacco was knee high, and I walked it that day, but they were plowing it that day. So now I continue to walk it the rest of the season after every rain. So it may have been that way all along. There's nothing been changed as far as fretting, you know, aggravating anybody or anything like that. It was just a misunderstanding. The son didn't mind me walking it, and apparently one of the other farmers did. So the last word I've got is I can't walk it until the crops are out, and that's what I got to go by, even if one of the other ones didn't mind. I certainly don't want to get run off, but I believe I can go down there and walk around the edge of the field, and if I had me one of them long grabbing tools, I could nab me some stuff, at least a couple of rows over in the field, and there ain't no doubt that I could see some stuff that far away. So I need to find out where and get one of them. But as soon as I can, and hopefully tomorrow, find a place I can go look in. It'll have to dry up a day or two on something that's planted, but tomorrow maybe I can get in some of the places where maybe it's just been turned and they've not got it planted yet, and find some pretty cool stuff. But I really appreciate y'all watching. And I appreciate this again, Paleo Man. You didn't have to do that, and it was a timely package, and I really, really appreciate it. That's awesome. I've tried that before, and I end up losing them ears every single time, nearly. I got much to learn. And I learned you got to get that base pretty thin in order to be able to go that far up in there with them notches. That's a sweet piece. Thanks again, buddy. I appreciate it. Later.